Okay, I bought this ass pillow for myself for when I sit on my chair. And apparently Kitty also likes it too. Every time I get my ass up, she wants to sit in it. Kitty, Kitty, you taking a nap? Yeah, she's like completely asleep. Why do you always steal my chair, Kitty? Why? Greetings, everyone! I'm just gonna adjust my mic! Greetings, humans! My name is Yashiroreaper, and welcome. Double checking that we're actually doing this good.
Welcome.
Yeah, we are good. We are good. We are here. Greetings! Welcome to my. Whatever, fucking hell. Welcome to the coffee stream! Welcome to the stream! Welcome to the stream! Welcome to the welcome to the welcome to the stream! Sorry there weren't any other streams this week, so I might end up playing a game later on, but basically, a fucking heat wave hit here. My landlord banned air conditioners, but then literally everyone in the apartment building was like, we're just gonna put ours in and fuck them. So I was like, okay, if everyone else is doing it, I'm fucking doing it, so I installed it. So now I have an air conditioner, so now I won't fucking die, and nor will my computer overheat so easily, because around here, it's not just like normal heat, it's like humidity high, like 93. So without the air conditioner, my computer, which is already heating up pretty bad on its own, was so overheated. And I was overheated, like I was a sweaty fucking mess. So, today is better. But I'll be coming in and out a bit because I had to do laundry. Yay, laundry. Because yesterday when I got home, I was like, okay, I'm going to take a little nap because I didn't sleep too well during the heat wave. Took a nap and then it started pouring fucking rain. I was like, well, I guess I'm not doing laundry today. I guess I have to do it tomorrow. So, laundry done. So I have like alarms set on my phone. So basically I'll like dip out for like a minute or two and then I'll be back. And, like, the first one is, like, pretty soon. Yeah, I got, like, 5 minutes or so till the first alarm goes off and I have to go check on my laundry. So, I'm doing some art. This one, I just thought it'd be kind of funny. I don't know who I'm doing it for. Also this one. Although I'm not into it. I don't even think I want to do this one. But, yeah. I am here. I am live. And just so you guys know, I'm going to pull it up on my coffee page right now. I changed my coffee thing because I realized during the heat wave that this computer is just, it's constantly just going to get filled out with more fur. Like, even when I clean it out, it's not going to stay that way forever because my cat likes to sleep on it. And if you know cats, you can't, like, I can't keep my cat on my laptop. I'm sorry. I'm not home all the time. She's gonna lay on it and her fur is gonna get in it. So a better solution I thought was just, I'm gonna change my goal to getting a desktop. Cause that she can't get as much fur into. And they're easier to clean. So I set up a goal, 1,200, cause I'm getting it for gaming too. So I wanna get a good one that can be good for gaming, good for me. And that's like monitor everything, because I had to buy a webcam if I get a desktop. So that's everything for the computer itself, for the webcam, and for the screen. So that's everything I'm going to be getting. So that's my new goal, and this is just for getting the laptop, because Kitty cannot leave this alone. And then I can use this for like watching shows and movies, which is what I originally planned to do. So. Yeah. So, if you want to help support me in getting a desktop so that I don't have as many streaming issues and my computer doesn't die on me, you can go check me out there and donate. You can donate however much you want, and whenever you donate, and if you have like an account or something, I'll send like when you buy me a coffee, I'll send like you a message and I'll do drawings or like any stream requests for people. Like, you're not just giving me money and I'm not gonna do anything. Like, I will thank you, I will give you art stuff, that kind of thing. And I'm also still doing art commissions. So if you want to know where to get an art commission from me, go hit me up, yashiroreaper@gmail.com, for all details and stuff like that, because I'm doing art commissions all the time. I thought about taking on fanfiction commissions, but considering how bad I am at keeping up with my own shit, probably not the best idea. Don't know if I want to do this one today. If I scroll through my bases. I like bases for streams because it takes me less time to, like, conceptualize. I live inside my own. Also, if you're listening to this music, like, yeah, I literally googled up, like. Also, I made myself an orange mash. I see the world through ice covered in cross all the ones who heard my cries and watched me weep. I love that. Because I got takeout today from, there's a board game cafe around here, and they have delicious food. And they finally opened up. And I was like, I need to get their food. I was going to get it yesterday, but then I cooked. So I was like, today I'm going to get it. Comic that I did forever ago. I might have posted it, but I didn't. It was just the photo of it, so I was like, you know what? I think it might be cute to kind of draw it, so that'll be one of my things for today. I also am going to be working on. I'm doing a gag series that I'm like writing. I'm trying to get as many of them done as I can before I start the series. Because it's a gag comic, so it's short panels. Kind of thing. So it's like one page, and it's got like usually 9 to 6 panels. So I was like, if I'm gonna do this, it's short, so I'm gonna do it full color. That takes a while. So I'm trying to get as many done as I can. And they're kind of done in this Kanye style. So I'm gonna be working on that. And of course, laundry's done. So I'll be right back. Literally, I'm going to like. This is the thing. This is one of them. It was based on, I found this knockoff of a Twix at the dollar store, and I adored it. So, I'm gonna draw that as well. And then I'll be working on this. I'll be drinking and eating. And doing laundry, because I'm an adult. I'm an adult. I do adult things. I am a dog. Okay, I'm gonna go grab dryer balls and go change over my laundry. Be back! I'm back! I swear! I swear. Just tripping on day. Dreams got dirty little lullabies playing on me. Might as well just rot around the nursery and count sheep. When it hurts like this. Climb the greatest heights, jump down and have a fight, and that's all we'll ever like, but that can never change my mind. When it's good, it's amazing. When it's bad, it's uneasy. I'm
times, but I'd never say goodbye or ever leave this stuff behind. When it's good, it's amazing. When it's bad, it's uneasy. I wouldn't have it another way. There's no other way, yeah. When it hurts like
because welcome to the life of a person who is a wreck of a human, to be honest. I'm sorry, humanity. I don't know what I'm doing. Also, I got like a grilled cheese. Mr. Deadliner, I swear to God. I promise. I know what I'm doing.
I can help you out. I can help you out. I can help you out. we go, here we go again. Time is up and I'm calling up my friends. Ain't no wonder why, ain't no wonder why too. Here we go again. Call me up and you wanna be my friend. I'm the one you ride, I'm the one you ride to. If you don't wanna change, ain't no place to hide, ain't no one to run to. If you don't wanna change, I can help you out.
God, brain, why am I fried? Probably because of heat stroke. That's like a few days I've been dealing with. Like, it's too hot, okay? I'm too Canadian for my own good. Heat does not do me well. Also, if anyone's like here for like I understand the world's going fucky again, because 2020 apparently. So I'm just gonna say this once. Fuckers listening to me. You're gonna be racist? Get the fuck out. I'm sorry. Sick of this fucking bullshit. Like, people just... Jesus fucking Christ, what century are we in, to be honest? I'm done with the world's bullshit. I'm done with stupid fucking America and their stupid bullshit. But at the same time, also remember that the virus is still a fucking thing. So be careful if you're gonna go out and do all that awesome protesty shit, cause you don't wanna be out there trying to get support and all this good stuff and then get the virus. Especially since some of the population that is going to be the most affected by this are the ones we're trying to protect during these whole riots, and they're the ones that, statistically speaking, probably don't have the health coverage, especially in America, to treat themselves for this. So, America, just chill the fuck out. You don't need to take everything to a fucking 11. You can breathe. Yeah, fuckers. Oh, close. Grilled cheese is a really good idea. I haven't had a grilled cheese in so long. I'm wondering, like, that doesn't make sense. You can go out and buy yourself bread and cheese. I know, but at the same time, I am also lactose intolerant. So I avoid buying cheese. But when I order out, that's when I can have cheesy goodness. Yes, I treat cheese and dairy products as a special. This grilled cheese sandwich is something I don't make at home, but oh my gosh. I'll close like not like a lazy one, like they actually put like spices and shit in it. I love this place. This is the one thing, like, my friend, her tattooing shop is literally opening up on Monday, which is super nice. But yeah, like, for a lot of the times, like, I haven't seen any of my friends, because, well, hers was one of the first places to go into quarantine, number one, because, well, she tattoos people. And when there's a viral infection, yeah, that's not the best time to be like, hey, for artistic purposes, let's just stab some holes into you. Like, no, that's a bad idea. Later. This is just getting the sketch idea out. If you're wondering who I'm saying this for, I'm saying it 98% for me. In our video. I don't think my cat does. But she's awake like 90% of the time. I heard her harness and I'm legit waiting for it to come in. Because she will be so happy when it comes in. No idea. We'll be right back. like, I don't know what it is about, like, summer, but, okay, I know exactly what it is. I am extremely heat intolerant, okay? Let me just explain that. Extremely heat intolerant, like, it's bad. I sweat profusely, and I literally have to drink almost like my body weight in water so I don't fucking get heat stroke. But 98% of the time I still get heat stroke anyways. Because yay. Also, I'm like in the midst of writing another fucking fanfic for Rhythmic. I'm sorry. It's called I Have No Control. This one's gonna be like it's sent to a fantasy world because I like fantasy. I don't know if you guys know this, but I really adore fantasy. Literally, one of my first tattoo is literally from a modern fantasy. Like, Hilda, I have Twig on my arm. I love fantasy. Fantasy is, like, one of my favorite genres. Like, any reading I do that isn't, like, light novels or stuff is fantasy. Like, I literally have a series on dwarves. Books like Dragonlance and Dragonforce as a band, Lord of the Rings, King Arthur, magic, all that kind of stuff. I also really like reading Warcraft books. I'm slightly disappointed that at Indigo, I think they got rid of the video game section, because I used to just raid that all the time for Warcraft books. And I miss it because I love Warcraft books. Like, I don't know why. I'm a big fantasy junkie. I think it's because, like, when I was a kid, like, a lot of my early exposure was, like, Lord of the Rings. Harry Potter was also a big thing when I was a kid. What else? I watched a lot of, like, fantasy TV shows. Fantasy has just always been my thing. So, like, when I got older, I just never wanted to give it up. So now I'm still, like, slightly obsessing over it. I'm like, oh my god, give it to me. I love me some fantasy. Okay. That's a lot of bread and a lot of cheese, but I don't complain. Also, I got like gummies. Back my orange mash. If you don't know what orange mash is, it's Jack Daniel's sour mash whiskey. About shot or two shots, depending on how strong you like it. And then usually about a can of orange crush soda. Or just any orange soda, but orange crush is usually what orange soda is around here. It is delicious. Literally, before I went out and bought myself like a normal thing of whiskey, this is the only way I could drink sour mash. Because sour mash, it needs to be mixed with something sweet, or else it's just a... Like, I tried to put it in cola, that was a bad decision, that was nasty. Like, I drank it, because I didn't want to waste cola or booze, but... It's much better with, like, something sweet, like an orange crush, or even, I believe, like, even, like, a cream soda I'd be good with. But I was the weird person that was like, oh yeah, I'm never gonna get into drinking. I didn't actually like enjoy drinking until probably I was 20, 21. If you don't understand, like, they're like, oh, that's the age illegal. I'm not American, I'm Canadian. We are legal at 19. The only thing I liked drinking at 19 was Guinness. And heavily mixed drinks. And now I actually like the taste of liquor. Like, I'm like, what the fuck happened? Like, why did my body suddenly to go from, I don't ever want to drink this disgusting liquid to, oh, this is good. Yeah, so I'm doing an Horizon Mac thing where they're kind of stuck in like a fantasy world. I was gonna do it like in a kind of almost mock fantasy, like the old times where it's like, we believe that this shit is real, but it's actually not. But then I was like, no, I want to make it slightly magical, so I'm making it magical! Because I'm a princess, motherfucker! If you don't get that reference, I'm sorry. I've been playing way too much Tales of Symphonia. And in Tales of Symphonia, there's Colette, and she's a fucking little princess, and I love her. She'd never say that, but in my brain, I'm like, you go, princess! She's not even a princess. I don't know. She's just adorable, and I just love her to bits, because I'm a crazy person. Also, erasing this because I forgot I'm supposed to do it like. But it's not like I need it. And you may have some history. But we don't have to repeat it. You made this mess and left me with the pieces. So yes, that is real Akuma. I actually own this pillow. It had a different pillow inside of it. Like, it actually had like a pillow wrapped up, but then that ripped in the wash. So me being me decided, hey, fuck it, I'm gonna fix it myself. So I bought like teddy bear stuffing and stuffed it, and it works fine, and now it's my favorite thing ever. The only difference is that you don't want to undo the zipper, or else the stuffing will collapse. Awesome, Meg is just adorable. And as a little surprise for myself, because I like to treat myself, because I'm probably because my mental health disorders where I'm just like, I should treat myself to stuff. So I bought myself an eraser mic sign. I'm so happy. It's coming. It's gonna be so great. It's literally, I think it's, yeah. First shipment for it is tomorrow. I'm pretty sure. She said June, so I'm assuming that means the 1st of June. I'm super excited because I bought it. I bought it off of Etsy. Literally, my first purchase off Etsy is fandom shit. So, that is... So if you guys understand, that's how far I am into this fucking world of fandom, okay? Literally the first thing I bought off Etsy ever is a fan yaoi sign. Hey. To be fair, if I had money like when I was like a teenager that I could willingly spend. Okay, let me explain about money when I was a teenager. I had money. But I was also fucking paranoid, because... Well, I was living in an abusive situation. Half an abusive home and half a good home. So I kind of hoarded money. Just in case. I needed to, number one, either flee! Or two, just in case he decided to, like, stop beating me. I guess that's where my brain went. So I literally just hoarded money so I could buy myself food.
Yeah.
And also so that I could move out. Like, once I was like in grade 12, like, I hoarded money specifically because I was like, yeah, I'm moving the fuck out as soon as I'm old enough, so I need to start saving up money for a place. Knowing how my parents, like, one parent is not financially stable enough to help me, and the other one uses money against me, so I should save money. affected my mental health, like, slowly over the last few years. Like, I've been doing content for... When I first started doing content, I was mentally very, very ill. And it's gotten better over the years that I've been doing content, like, I was very ill. Now I'm kind of, like, pretty chill with everything. Like, if you go back, like, this goes up on my YouTube channel. So if you're watching this later on my YouTube channel, go, like, go back and look at my early content, and you can tell how fucking ill I was, mentally. Now I'm in, like, a much better place. And it's a lot easier for me now to, like, talk about things that I used to never speak about. Or at least when I spoke about it, it, like, got me into a tizzy. Like, a lot of my old content, like, if I talked about a lot of my childhood, like, it was tear fest. And now I'm just like, yeah, that's the shit I did when I was a kid. Like, kind of better with it. So, if, like, some people come onto these streams, I don't think they understand, like, this is, these streams I do on this day are literally just to promote, like, the fact that I have a coffee! Coffee helps with everything I do, from my gaming, to my streaming, to my art, to everything. Basically, all my online content I do is supported by my coffee. Like, if I get, like, one of my coffee tiers at some point is going to be getting myself Grammarly. If you don't know what Grammarly is, it is, like, a program that you can buy, and, like, it helps you with grammar. And I'd use that for my fanfics and stuff. Look away so you won't see, 'cause the pain is in my eyes. Break it any moment and shatter your insides. If you feel my mind, call me all night long. Try to give you hints and a heart to I like it. I like being able to do stuff like this where I'm just kind of chilling out with you guys, because I live alone currently, so I get pretty bored. Especially during quarantine, oh my god, you guys have no idea. Like, for a while there, like, when shops weren't open, like, especially since I live downtown, And like one of the first things to go was the bus routes. Like now the bus is for essential workers, so I wouldn't want to go on it. So like a lot of outside or just social things was immediately cut off for me early. So I've been kind of going slightly stir crazy. Like during this I realized I'm more extroverted than I think. Like I'm an introvert. And I always thought like I leaned more towards introversion. But now I'm like, oh no, it's a bit more balanced. Cause for a prolonged period of time, if I go without it, like, I did not handle that as well as I thought I would. Like, I'm just like, I need social human interaction, Jesus Christ, I didn't know how much I needed this in my life. I thought I was a normal introvert with slight extroversion. No. I have way more extroversion than I originally thought, and I need to fulfill it. So I'm like, okay, maybe given the state of the world is in now, and basically, like, I don't know if you guys, if people in the world, I don't know, like, how many people are actually realizing this, but the fact that this happened means that this kind of thing, over the years, will become more common. That's just the way it is with the world, especially considering, like, what's the best way to put it? The reason, like, this virus got, like, so out of control, and it's been this kind of thing has been developing for years. Like, it started with, like, remember, like, the big thing was swine flu, where that was able to be easily more contained than this. And if you know why, do you know why? Like, as the years go by, we are getting more and more kind of like a globally kind of, like, we're globally kind of being, what's the word? I'm trying to remember the word, I'm sorry. My brain is not that smart. But yeah, basically, as we're becoming more globally as, like, a world, like, countries are more connected now than they ever have been. And in a lot of ways, it's very good, but there are some downsides. And the downsides are related to something like this happening. Turns out, it's a lot harder to isolate a disease like this when we have such a globally established world. So, like, now that the first one's happened, it's not like, oh, cool, we got this. The world's not that smart. Things like this are gonna happen a few more times, I would say. So I'm realizing that, okay, if this is gonna become a bit more of a regular thing, I should probably, for my own mental health, move in with someone so I don't go fucking stir crazy during this. And people are thinking I'm being, like, catastrophizing. No, I'm just speaking, this is just logically, like, I'm sorry, humanity as a whole is kind of fucking dumb, okay? Some places are just so dumb. Like, America, I have a question for you. I understand you're protesting against COVID. Do you think the disease is going to listen? Are you anthropomorphizing a pandemic? Or do you think the disease is made up by the government? That's a legit question I have. Every day I hear that someone's like protesting the disease, I'm like, you're what? Do you think it listens? Do you think Corona's just gonna be like, oh, sorry, man, I didn't realize I was doing so much damage. It doesn't do shit! Here's a little fun fact about me. Back in high school, we got to do a presentation on a major historical event. Some people were like, oh, I'm gonna do King Tut. I did the Black Plague. I did some heavy research on the Black Plague. And now I'm starting to get more into where I want to do more research on the Black Plague, because I'm seeing some weird things in the world where I'm just like, this fucking happened? I gotta know! Like, obviously, they didn't know as well as we did, because, like, you know, the plague doctor mask. Like, they literally were like, oh, it's the bad air, we'll put some smelly things so that, oh, we don't get it. I have questions, though. Based on their logic, were they doing weird shit like this, too? I have questions, because a lot of people say, like, in a lot of ways, our society's dumber. People are fucking dumb. Like, you ever heard of like old times, like when a place would get sieged and like they had a walled in town or village or something like that? People would protest to open them up. And if you know what that means, back then, a lot of times they didn't leave anyone in those places alive. And if you live, you didn't want to be alive. So, some creepy parallels. Humans were always dumb. I just have questions now. Wondering why I chose the Black Plague in high school as a history project. Let me explain. A lot of my we did presentation like whole like bring up the whole bar shit. Don't give a shit. That isn't the only thing I did that was weird as a child. Let's just say, I'm a big documentary person. Like, a good documentary, especially a history one, you got me. I'm sorry, you do. Documentaries are my shit. Especially ancient history ones. But when I was younger, I also watched some like more modern medical ones. So another weird project I did that creeped out every girl in school and literally had three people gagging was I did the Tree Man. If you don't know who the Tree Man is, it's a man that was covered in a certain wart that spread so much that he literally looked like Groot. Yeah, like he was slowly turning to Groot. But instead of tree bark, it was warts. And I did a whole project. Because I'm the crazy kid. And when I did bubonic plague, I also made the ointment that they used to put on people's bodies and had it in a container. And had guys daring each other to sniff it and then almost puking. It was good. I took great pleasure in being able to, like, make the guy. Like, guys would be like, oh yeah, let's do this manly thing. And I'm like, bitch, I will beat you. And they're like, what? And I'm like, oh yeah, let's drag these guys around in like this cart that's used for keeping all of our shit underneath the stage. Like, cool. You know what I'm gonna do? Oh god, what is she gonna do? I'm gonna drag the most guys on it, and then I'm going to break it, And then I'm going to swear you off to secrecy about me breaking it. Yep, did that in grade 8. Broke something and never told anyone. And years later, people would be like, oh god, it broke! And I'd be like, actually, I broke that like 4 years ago. Sorry. They're like, what? I'm like, yeah, I broke that in 8th grade. We decided not to tell anyone. And we didn't. Same as when one of my friends, because he's a fucking little troll, he used to literally run out of class, like, go to the bathroom. He'd bring bags of chips and microwave them in this old dinosaur. We called it Dora. It was this dinosaur of a fucking... It looked like a convection oven. Or toaster oven, as you guys call it. But it was a microwave. Had a dial and all that shit. And he would microwave chip bags in it. So they shrunk. And made blue lightning. And then when they were renovating the school, right before they closed the gym, like 2 months before they closed the gym for renovations, he pissed in the fountain in there. And we told no one. Because we could not let it live after the fact that we're like, someone fucking drank out of that fountain after this guy pissed in it. And we can't be the ones to tell them that. So you know what we're gonna do? We're just not gonna tell anyone. We're just gonna die with the secret buried deep in our souls. Welcome to Redneck High. Okay, I gotta go change our laundry again. Laundry time! Kitty's like, what? 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 Oh, sorry. I'll be back. I'll be back to do more art, I swear. First load's back. Yay. And it had my Squishmallows. Don't know what Squishmallow is. Basically, it's a teddy bear that's super, like, swishy. Like, the softest fucking thing in the world, and I use it as pillows. Yep. I have bamboo pillows and all that shit. Like, if you know what bamboo pillows are. You know, like, those are comfy AF. I still choose to sleep on Squishmallows. Because that's how soft they are. Come on. Hi, I forgot I turned off autoplay. Sorry!
Hold me close till I get up. Time is barely on our side. I don't wanna waste what's left. The storms we chase are leading us. And love is all we'll ever trust. Yeah. No, I don't wanna waste what's left. And on we'll go. Through the wastelands, through the highways. Till my shadow turns to sun rays. And on we'll go. Through the wastelands, through the highways. And on.
So yes, I know how horrible this is. This is literally just me sketching it out so that I can do it better. Just getting my ideas out, I swear. I'm better at drawing than this, I swear. We'll be right back. sets up as a comic that I can work on later. I've been streaming for how long? About 20 minutes? Had to switch to another piece. That's gonna take forever. Also, like, I'm still eating this, I swear to God. I'm gonna have a very small dinner, fine. I can feel it. Mostly because I've been eating, like a good hour, 20 minutes. And I'm still not even done with my sandwich. And I got french fries with it, so. So if you want something to hold on to, gotta find it first. But here I am, 'cause I've been laying under palm trees waiting for the summer, knowing there's nowhere to go. 'Cause I am happy on this island, wanna be. I might redo this. This one.
Thank you.
That's super cute. I'm just gonna refine that. That looks a little better. Okay, I finished my grilled cheese, and I can move on to chips. I mean, fries. Canadian. I'm not half asleep, slightly drunk, and waiting for laundry. So you know I'm a cheap ass drunk. It used to be worse when I was still on a lot of medical marijuana. People who don't know, but I actually was on medical marijuana for a few years. I've been off it for 5 months now. So, like, I kind of know how easily I used to get drunk. Like, it was bad. I'm sorry. Thank you. in my head canon. Razorhead, instead of actually getting like a necklace, like his ring doesn't go on his finger. It never has. It's always been the necklace. And he specifically got it a bit bigger, so it'd be harder to recognize as an actual wedding ring. Mike wears his underneath his glove, but he's like, he wears a lot of jewelry, so he wasn't as worried about like people finding out that he had a wedding ring on. But Razorhead, on the other hand, not known for wearing jewelry, so he wears this, just this necklace. So Mike is a little extra bitch. Anyone who doesn't think like he's slightly extra with life obviously has never seen him! Look at him! He's a queen! so cute. Looks like that extra little bitch. My fries are already cold.
Give me reasons to doubt, try to keep me down, but I'll put the flame out. You can't get to me. Throw your sticks and your stones, go break all of my bones. You won't eat
almost that pizza.
You can't get to me.
But then I know Squirting Cafe was open today, and I was like, yeah. Mostly wanted to fix like a cheese thing.
To the ground, what goes around comes around. You won't put the flame out, you can't get to me. Say what you want to say, go take it all away. But I'm here to
look at my little extra bitch. Me.
And there is no barricade that I can tear away. Shoot me down.
First cocktail done. Woo. I thought I was going to work on my GAC con today, but probably not, looking at the time, because I was almost in 2 hours. Sorry for probably one of the weirdest streams you've probably watched by me. I'm sorry, guys. It's supposed to be my coffee streams. Would be better at streaming, but be better at streaming. Wow. Let's go on to this. Let's go check on laundry again. I'll be back with more laundry.
Thank you.
Welcome to Yashiroreaper's house chores. Sorry, I'm out of breath. I'm not out of shape. The sun's pollen out. And I'm out of shape. Mostly pollen dust. I like to imagine that Mike's mustache like took him for a fucking ever to grow. And, like, he holds on to it like, I grew a mustache, finally! And that's why he takes like such good care of it. He's like, this is my mustache. It took me 8 years to grow. Meanwhile, as I was just like, I forgot to shave for 2 days and now I look like a hobo. It's gonna be a weird stereotype, but I've seen it true. The darker your hair is, the more likely you are to, like, look more kind of, like, shaggy. Because a lot of blondes, like, their pigments in their hair can be fairly light. So, they could technically have a lot of facial hair, but it's such a light color that it's almost impossible to tell. Because my nephew is, he's 15, and he's like at that age where he's trying to grow facial hair. He's like, I feel some, but I can't see it. And I'm like, yeah, that's because you have blonde hair. You'll be lucky if anyone can ever notice that you have facial hair. And he's like, sorry. You weren't blessed like your uncle to have brunette hair. Well, not brunette, like dirty blonde. Because his uncle had dirty blonde hair, he was able to grow a red hot beard. My nephew, he's too blonde. So his facial hair is not coming out at all, so he's just this like little bib of fist forever. Although he's got a deep ass fucking voice. Like, he was a deep ass voice when he was 2. And when his voice started deepening, I was like, what the fuck, boy? Like, what? And I'm like, you already sounded like a 40-year-old smoker. Now you sound like an even worse smoker. And he's like, what? And I'm like, you have such a deep voice, dude. I'm jelly. I have a kind of weird relationship with my nephew, mostly because we're so close in age, I think. That in a weird way, it's almost kind of like we're siblings, less than aunt and uncle. Nephew.
Eyes in the sky, gazing far into the night. I raise my hand to the fire, but it's no use, cause you can't stop.
I always laugh when his mother's like, don't curse around my son. And I'm like, your son is on YouTube. And I know the people he watches. They curse just as much as me. I'm like, what do you mean? I'm like, you really need to watch some of the YouTubers he watches. She's like, no, I don't like YouTube. And I'm like, then you're never gonna understand what he's actually watching, hon. My nephew, like, he's been watching Markiplier, and then he also watched Tabuscus. And he watches Jacksepticeye, and my nephew, my brother is also getting him into Vine Sauce, so I'm like, you don't understand what your son actually like watches. Like, hun, your son He's heard all the curse words I'm saying before. That's why I've always put a laugh where she's like, oh, we're not gonna let him watch Monty Python on the Holy Grail yet. And I'm like, he's heard worse humor on the internet. Anything that's slightly worse, he just won't get. Like, what? I'm like, you think I don't know what my nephew watches on the internet? Half of what he watches, he found from me. Okay. Right now, his mother's kind of keeping him busy with renovating. Because my sister's like, quarantine, perfect time to renovate. They've done 3 bathrooms, trim on the house, and then a storage room. They split it off into 2 rooms. And now they're doing, like, they're outside. I'm like, oh my god, my nephew. Literally, whenever I see him online on stream, on, like, Steam, I'm like, oh my god. He's free!
But it's no use, 'cause you can't stop it from shining through. It's true, baby, let the light shine through. If you believe it's true, baby, won't you let the light shine through.
The more I draw him with the necklace, the more it's reminding me of, like, the one true ring from Lord of the Rings. And you know what? I'm okay with that. Also, I realized I, like, began a topic, like, 10 minutes ago and then totally forgot it. You know, talking about, like, doing a fantasy universe. So their quirks eventually are considered magic in that universe. Because, like, people have magic. Some people don't, but most people have magic. And she's just, like, being associated, like, her magic's just being associated with it. Like, oh, this man can, like, screen trees up. That's a powerful magic spell. And he's like, I kind of quirk, but sure. Also, yes, it does have an adoptive family shit. Because I have a genre. Anyone who doesn't know, 98% of my fanfiction is, like, it has something to do with family, okay? Whether it's someone having a kid and then becoming a family, or legit, like, hello, I'm here and I'm adopting children. I have a genre and I'm sorry. We'll be working on writing some fan fiction later. Woo. Hopefully not take a fucking nap. Sorry, my day's off. I am, like, super lazy. I don't know what it is. My brain's just like, hey, you have to get up tomorrow. Like you have to be up and, like, going by 8. But, like, before 8, so I'm like, okay. I don't know. I think it's on my days off. My brother's just like, yeah, we have to get up early. We're gonna nap. And I'm like, brain, no. I have things I want to do. It's okay. Cute. You're not doing them, though. We'll be right back. Meg is such a cute little bean. But I can tell you for sure, like, he also totally has some, like, little gremlin energy. But I'm cool with this, because I find it's adorable. Maybe because I'm a little gremlin. Not to say I can't wait for the buses to get back on schedule, because I really need to go get myself some summer clothes. And I don't want to have to pay for a taxi. Summer clothes, I literally mean I'm buying like thin shirts, tank tops, and then some fucking like soccer, like basketball, like shorts. Cause that's what I do. I'm not kidding. I legit wear basketball shorts during summer when I can. Because lady fashion, I don't know what the fuck you're doing, but none of your shorts are actually fucking shorts. They are underwear at best. Not about you, but anyone who has any sort of thigh can't wear that shit. And now I have thighs. Also, just like men's fashion is like 98% more comfy than 98% of the time. And also more breathable. Ladies, why are we putting up with this bullshit? I'm not joking. Like, literally, why are we putting up with, like, uncomfortable clothes? Do we think men actually care? Because I can tell you, 98% of men don't give two flying fucks. Oh my god. Oh my god. Keep playing my tunage, assholes. my air conditioner. And everyone's like, oh, you got an air conditioner this year. I'm like, I had it last year. He's like, what? I'm like, bruh, 2 days ago I wore a hood up and you didn't even recognize who I was. I'm not joking, my neighbor. My neighbor who talks to me a lot didn't recognize who I was with a hoodie up. I was like, bruh. I like literally pulled down the hoodie. He's like, ah, oh, that's you. And I'm like, yes. Yes, it's me. A lot less recognizable than people think. I'm like, what the fuck? It's because I grew up in a small town. In a small town, like, everyone recognizes you because welcome to the fucking world. And I'm like, stop recognizing me. Okay, whatever. Oh yes, I totally love the idea that Eraser has like these ugly, hot pink track pants. That just screams, I don't give a shit. And I like it. Thank you. Oh my god, people. What the fuck are you doing? Lawnmowing equipment, or did someone beef up their car? Cause if it's the latter, fuck you, you asshole. Yeah, I have a thing against, like, I don't know. Probably from my high school years, but anyone who, like, soups up their car to make it sound fucking loud as shit. You're an asshole. And I hate you. Literally make your car shut the fuck up. I'm satisfied with this shit. Going to shade the sentence and look better than it looks like right now. I finished one drawing. I'm pleased with myself. I also got a ton of laundry done. Also, I didn't forget to set the timer. Of, I've been constantly leaving, so I'm like, is this disturbing long enough? Oh gosh. Oh so sad conventions are closed this year, because I, right in my city, is literally, it's called Anime Advertising. It's a big anime convention during the summer, but it's canceled this year. And I'm so sad, because I was going to try to get into Artist Alley this year, but blah, 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 blah. I'll try again next year. Any other really old shitty pieces I'm gonna try to revive? My brain's like, you still want to draw, right? I'm like, yeah, but I don't know what. Maybe I'll start this one. See where I go with it.
changes.
Very embarrassed, Mike, because he's like, I got the kids!
Thank you.
Yep. Alright guys, so thank you very much for watching the stream. Hopefully you enjoyed. If you want to check out more of my streaming goodness, I stream every Wednesday, Thursday, and Sunday. Especially now that I got the air conditioner in. As long as there are no technical issues, I will be streaming every day. Those 3 days. Sundays usually starts at noon Eastern Standard Time. And Wednesday, Thursday, it is usually at 4 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Wednesday, Thursday, I do gaming, and Sunday, I do art and coffee streams. So I love you guys so, so very much. If you want to help me and support all the streaming goodness I do, you go check me out at coffee.com/Yashiroreaper. That is coffee.com/Yashiroreaper. My current goal is to get myself a desktop. Also, you can follow me up on Twitter, because that's where I post a lot of stuff and where I announce streams and things like that, other than this quick announcement here. I'm not a Yashiroreaper all across the web. I'm on DeviantArt. I am on Instagram, I am on Twitter, I am on so many places. If you see Yashiroreaper, it's fucking me, okay? I love you all so, so very much, and I will see you in the next stream. Bye. Also, this is going to blow up on my YouTube channel. All stream recordings go there. Love you. Mwah. Bye. Okay, now where is the thing? Stop doing this. Stop closing when I'm streaming. Okay. Again. Bye. Bye.
Come along with me and the butterflies and bees, where we can wander through the forest and do so as we please. So come along with me to a cliff under a tree, where we can gaze upon the water as an everlasting dream. All of my collections, I'll share them all with you. And maybe by next summer, we won't have changed our tunes. We'll still want to be in this cliff under a tree, making up new numbers and living so merrily.